Hey guys, first off, congratulations for making it to the last episode in this series. It really has been a long series, and if you've watched all the videos from the first episode to this last episode, then you should be in a very good position with your skills in PHP and MySQL, as well as design with CSS. So, although this is the last episode in the series, I still plan on creating another video, at least one video, in which we are not going to do any coding. In that video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just go over the entire project and do some explanation and suggestions and so on. So basically what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to explain why I did things in a certain way and what the advantages are of doing things one way instead of the other. I'm also going to provide suggestions on how you can make the application, you can improve the application and make it even better. And also, I'm going to compile all the feedback and the questions that I've been getting on the entire series from the first episode to the last episode. I'm going to compile all the feedback, the questions and so on, and I'll address all of them in that particular video. So look out for that video. If you haven't yet subscribed, you can subscribe now so that when I upload the video, you will get notified. And I also plan on talking about a Udemy course I plan on creating, but I haven't yet fully formed the idea, so I don't have much to say about it now. Probably in that video, I'll also tell you more about it. Okay, so now let's get to the purpose of this video. So what we are going to do in this episode is to implement the feature to view all the posts under a particular topic and the ability to read more posts by clicking on the read more button or the title of the post so that you can be taken to the single.php page where the details of the article and the article itself is being displayed for the user to read. So let's open our code base. So the first thing we'll do is we'll go to the index.php file and make sure that we are connecting this file to the single.php. So we scroll to the areas where we're displaying our posts, and then we look for the title, which is here. And we make sure it is being sent to the single.php page. And not only that, we also make sure we are sending a variable called id, which is the id of the post, because you are going to use this id on the single page to fetch that particular post from the database and then display it. We are going to do a similar thing for the read more button and the title of these other posts. So we look for the title, here it is, display this, and the same thing for the read more button. So if we go back now to our browser and refresh, we can now click on an article and it will take us to the single.php page, and here we can see it is also passing the ID of that article. Okay, so the next step is to grab that ID on the single post.php page, fetch the post from the database and display it. So we open single.php and we are just going to do that up here. The first thing we will do is we will include our post controller file. So we use our root path variable, which takes us to the root path of the project, and then we enter the app folder, controllers folder, and then our posts.php file. The reason we are doing this is so that we can have access to our database file in this single.php file, because our database.php file, that is our db.php file, is already being included inside the post.php file. So having done that, we can now fetch our post using the select one function we defined earlier. And this select one function takes a second argument, which is the condition. And because we are sending the ID of the post to this page, we are just going to fetch that ID from the URL. And in order to do that, we are going to use the get superglobal and the name of the variable as key. And usually we want to make sure that this variable exists before we are using it. So what I will do is I'm just going to do an if statement. So if that variable is set before we can use it, otherwise our application might throw an error. So as usual, what I will do is I'll just display this on the page and just to confirm that it is actually fetching the post. Back to our browser, we refresh our index page and then we click on the post, and we can see here that it fetches the post and displays it on the browser. Alright. Okay, so the next step now is to display this on our page. First thing I'm going to do is I will scroll down to the title tag of this page, and in this title tag I will display the post title. Now the reason I'm doing this is to improve on the search engine optimization. So when they search this article on Google, when they provide keywords related to this title on Google, Google will more easily recognize this your page, and it will improve on your ranking. And usually what I do is I'm just going to add the name of the website. Yeah, you can add the name of the website here so that your users, when they view this on browser, on the Google search results, they will know the website that this is coming from. And yeah, they'll make your website more popular. Okay, so that is it. Down here, we are also going to display the title on the page. So I'm just going to copy this and replace this hard-coded title here. And then this is the body within the post content tag. I'm just going to delete all these paragraphs that I hard-coded. I select all of them and delete. And inside here, I'm going to display the body of the content, but I'm going to wrap it around an HTML entity decode function so that it can decode the HTML tags. Okay, so having done this, you can refresh this page now and you can see that it is fetching our post directly from the database. And if you take a look at the title tag here, you see that it displays the title as well as the name of the website. Okay, so that is it for this single page. Now for the popular posts on the sidebar here, this is simply just fetching posts and displaying them. And let's just do that real quick. So up here, I will create another variable called posts with S. And we're going to select all from the posts table where published equal true. So when we do this, all we need to do now is scroll down to this area. We'll delete all the other items save one, so that we can use it to loop and display those coming from the database. So we do our good old for each loop for the posts. And for each post, we are going to display this HTML. and we'll replace the title with the title that's coming from the database. And you know what? I just realized this variable name is the same as the single post variable name. So I don't want any confusion. I'll just make this P. I'll just make it P to avoid confusion. And here we are displaying the title. And here the image. Again, we use the base URL to get to the root of the application. Then we step into the assets folder, images folder, and then here we display the post image. Back to our browser, if we refresh the single page, we can see now that these popular posts are coming from the database. So that is it for the single.php page. Now our next task is to display all the posts under a particular topic when a user clicks on that topic. But before we get to that, I just realized that we left one thing on the single page. Unlike on the index.php page, all these topics you see here are being hard-coded on the single page. So as you can see here, we are hard-coding them. So what we need to do is, we also need to pull this from the database. We need to loop through our topics, which we haven't yet fetched, but which we are going to do immediately after this. So for each topic, we are going to display the name of that topic. I don't know whether I called it name or title. I think it's name. Let me just verify that in the index.php page. So here are the topics. Yeah, I called it name. So here it will be name, and then when you click on the topic, it's going to take you to the index.php page in the root folder. And when it takes you to that page, it is going to send with it the ID of the topic. Let me just say t underscore id to mean the topic. And that will be topic ID. So what I did was I displayed the name of the topic, and on the link surrounding the topic, the href attribute, I am setting it to point to the index page, and I am passing as parameter the topic ID. So this is also what you are supposed to do on the index page. I'm just going to copy this and replace it here so that the anchor tag will also be automatically applied. So when you click on this link also, it takes you to the same index.php page with the topic ID. Later on, we will take this topic ID and fetch all posts belonging to this topic and then display it. Now up here, we are fetching topics. I think we did that inside the topics controller. So let me open to that. So we are fetching all topics here. I'm just going to copy it, come over to the single.php page, and I will also fetch topics. So this makes our topics available on the single page, and if we refresh the page, I think we made a mistake. Topics, we scroll down. Topic. Okay, I think we did not add our percent sign here. And because we copied this over to the index.php page, It means that mistake got repeated here too. So let us fix it. And then we refresh now and our errors are gone. So these topics are now coming from the database. Now we want the user to view all posts under a particular topic when they click on it. And in order to do that, we are also going to define another database function. So we come to our code base and we open to our db.php file. So our get, we're going to define a function which we will call get our topic posts or get posts by topic. By topic ID, which will take the topic ID and then fetch all articles under that topic. So our query is going to be the same as we had up here in the get published posts. The only difference here is that we are going to add another clause called and topic ID equal, we add a placeholder. Now down here we are going to add the data for that particular field, the topic ID equal the topic ID that is being passed to the function. So when we do this, our get posts by topic ID method will select username and all the attributes of the post from the post and the users table on this condition, and then where the article is published and the topic ID is the ID that the user clicked on, is the ID of the topic that the user clicked on. So yeah, this function becomes automatically available inside our index.php page. So what we will do is we will add another if statement, and we are saying if it's a get request and the ID of the topic, we named it as simply t underscore ID. So if the t underscore ID variable is set, then our posts will be all posts belonging to that topic. And in such cases, we can just change this following if statement into an else if statement so that we just have one or the other. So at any time, if you have selected topic, all the posts that are being displayed are the posts under that topic. If you have entered a search term, all posts being displayed are posts matching that search term. Otherwise, if you haven't clicked on any topic and if you haven't searched for any posts, it is just going to display the normal published post. I also want to set the title up here in the case where you clicked on a particular topic. So what I want to do is you searched for posts under and then here we get the topic name. So what I will do is I could use this ID, the topic ID, to get the topic name from the database, but that would be a very long process and it will be slow for our application. So what I will do is when I am sending the ID of the topic, I will send the name of the topic as well. So I scroll down here where I am sending the topic ID. So after sending one variable, we can attach another variable by using an ampersand and then giving the name of that variable. When we do that, we can append the name of the topic. Okay, so the name variable automatically becomes available also on the parameter list. So I'll copy this and replace it in the singular.php page so that the same thing happens when you click on a topic. So up here, in the index.php page, you can now change this to be the get super global variable with the name of the topic that was selected. We save this, come back to our browser and refresh. And if we click on life, for instance, you can see the title reads the search for posts under life. And here we have the variables that are being sent in the parameter list. And we have all articles belonging to the topic life. You can click on quotes and it will also bring all the articles under quotes. So this is it for the feature. If you go to the single post article also, you can click on the title and it will bring you all posts under that topic. So this is it for that feature. The next thing we are going to do is middleware, which is a very important feature. It's actually access control, that is restricting access to certain functionality only to admin users and others only to logged in users and so on. So we are going to implement it using a concept of middleware, which is basically a functionality that sits between a request and the response to that request. So it's actually a lot easier than it sounds. All you're going to do is create a couple of functions that we will execute before we perform any task that is considered restricted. So let us create our middleware functions. The first thing we'll do is we'll open to the helpers folder inside the app folder and create a file called middleware.php. Inside this file, we are going to define our middleware functions. The first function, we'll call it the users only function. And what this function does is when you execute it before a certain functionality, it is going to restrict that functionality only to logged in users. The next function, we are going to call it the admin only. And if you want to restrict a certain part of your code only to admin users, you can execute this function right before that functionality. And lastly, we have the guests only. And this function is used to restrict access to pages like the login page and the register page from users that are already logged in. So if you're already logged in, it doesn't make sense for you to view the login and the register page again. So we'll execute this function right before at the top of those pages so that the user will be redirected away from it once they try to visit it. Now I'm going to give each of these functions a default parameter called redirect, which specifies the path to which the user should be taken to in case any of these checks fail. So if you execute this and the user is found to be not logged in, they will be taken to the index.php page. So all we are going to do in this function is to check if the user is logged in. So if the user is not logged in, which means if they don't have their value in the session, such as the ID, it means they are not logged in. And if they are not logged in, we're going to set a session message that simply says you need to log in first. And then we will set a second session message called type, which just specifies the type of the message that exists in the session, whether it's an error or a success message. And in this case, it is an error message. So if the user is found to be not logged in, which means if they don't have ID in the session, we will redirect them to to the index page. So we'll just attach our redirect to it, this value. But before we do that, we'll put the base URL variable, which will make sure that it has the absolute path. It takes the user to the home page, and then from there it proceeds to the index.php page. And of course, after every redirect, we exit. So I'll copy this and reproduce it in the admin section. And we were also saving the admin property of every user in the session. So in this case, we'll just check if they are not admin user. But first of all, we will also check if they are not logged in. So if they are not logged in, or they are logged in but they are not admin user, then we'll say you are not authorized. And this will redirect them to the index.php page. Lastly, for the guests only function, we are going to check if they are logged in. If they are logged in, then we don't even need to set any message. So I'm going to remove the message. Instead, all we are going to do is we redirect them back to the index page, because they don't need to view the pages that are belonging only to the guest, that is the authentication pages. So this is it. We have created all the functions. Now let us start applying them. First of all, we will open the admin section, and pretty much every page in this admin section belongs or is supposed to be accessed only by the admin user. The create, for example, we can just invoke it right here, and it will redirect the user if they attempt to access this page without being admin users. So we'll do the same for the edit page. Only admin users can edit, as well as the manage posts page. We open to the topics folder in the admin section, and we do the same. The edit file also, we will paste our function here, because only admin users can edit. The same thing with manage topics. And lastly, we will also come to the users folder and do the same. And the dashboard also is only accessible to the admin user. And this is it. By doing this, all our admin pages have been restricted only to the admin users. Now we can open to our controllers file and begin to restrict some functionalities too. To get one post, anybody can get it, including a public user, because they might want to read it. To delete a post, however, is supposed to be done only by the admin user, so we place this here. To publish a post is supposed to be done only by the admin user. To add new post is supposed to be done only by admin user, so before even executing anything, we need to perform that check. The same thing with update, and that's all for the post controller. We open to the topics controller, and only an admin user can add topic. We can just leave this one to select a topic by ID. As for delete topic, only admin user can do that, as well as update topic. We open our users file and we do the same. Anybody can log in. Anybody can register, but to update user, to update user, let me see. For now, only admin can update user, so let's just put this here, because we haven't implemented admin update functionality like update profile for the normal user. So the update functionality only occurs in the back end, and only admin should do that. To get a particular user, we're going to leave it like this. To log in, anybody can log in. To delete a user, only admin can delete it, because again, we haven't implemented the normal user profile where they can update their account and maybe delete their account if they want. So for now, only admin can delete an account. And then the next middleware we need to use is the guest only middleware, which, like I said, only applies to the auth pages. So we will execute it before we display our login page as well as our register page. Okay, so that is it. Now for this users only functionality, we don't yet have any particular actions that we want to restrict only to logged in users. Most of the restrictions are for admin users, because most of the functionality is being done by the admin user. So if you are only a normal user, you can view and read articles without necessarily logging in. If we had functionality such as commenting, then we would have used the users only middleware to restrict commenting only for logged in users. So this function just exists for now in case you want to provide functionality that is specific only to logged in users. And so that is it for access control. If I log out and let me see, log in again as a normal user. Let me sign up. And I think we made a mistake. We forgot to include our middleware file in the files that we are using the functions. So here I'm just going to open the controllers, and inside each of these controllers I'll just include the middleware file. So here I'll just include middleware.php, and because we are using this post controller inside the inside all the three files in the admin section, we don't need to include middleware again inside the admin section. So our middleware file will be automatically available inside create.php, for example, because we are also including the controller file. So that is why I'm going to include the middleware file inside all controllers, and I won't need to bother myself about the admin pages. And of course the login and the register pages, I don't need to since I've already included it inside the controllers for the user's controller file. So if I refresh this, it works now. I'm going to create an account. So right now I have logged in as a normal user. If I attempt to visit, let's say, the create page for topic, it says I am not authorized. The same thing with the other pages such as the users and so on. I won't be able to visit those pages. And even if I somehow manage to get myself to the, let's say, the create post page, and I fill the form and submit, it is still going to perform the check and it will find that I'm not an admin user, and it will redirect me back. But now let me log out and then log in as an admin user, and I'll be able to visit all my admin pages. And while I am here on the users page, I realize one of my viewers asked me to implement the ability for the admin user to edit a normal user and maybe change them into an admin user or something. So what I need to do is to make sure that this table that you see here fetches all users, including the normal users, instead of just admin users. So all I'll do is, I will go to the users controller file that is inside the app controllers folder. And instead of selecting all users where admin is set to 1, I will just select all users and save it. So when I do this and I refresh this page, you see now that it is bringing all the users from the database, and I can upgrade a user to an admin user. And I just realized there is a mistake with that particular form. This user is not an admin user, so when I click on it, I don't expect this to be selected, because if you check in our database, that particular user has 0 as the admin property. So let us go to the edit page for admin user and see if we are performing the right check. And this seems to be okay here. So let me open to the app controller file, the controller file for user, where we are fetching the user from the database and filling the form. Okay, so when we fetch the user from the database, obviously the admin property is set. And if it is set, then this value will always be 1. So what we need to do is, we are going to check if this admin property is equal to 1, then we will give our admin variable the value 1, otherwise we will give it the value 0. So we go back to our browser and refresh, and now it works. If we go now and click on an admin user, you see that it is checked. If you click on a user that is not admin, it is not checked. Another way to do this is, you simply just leave it like this. If this value is 1, it will give our admin variable the value 1. If it is 0, it will give our admin variable the value 0. So we don't need any condition. So back on our browser, if we refresh, you will see that it still works the same way, even for the admin user. So this is a mistake that escaped my notice. If not for that, my subscriber or that viewer who asked for this feature, I probably wouldn't have seen it. So yeah, here you have it. If you want to upgrade this user to an admin user, all you need to do is check the admin option and provide the password, and that user will become an admin user. If you check the database, you can now see that they have the value 1 as admin user. So this brings us to the end of this series on how to create a blog with PHP and MySQL database. I hope it has been as good a journey to you as it has been to me. I enjoyed creating the videos very much, even though they were very tiring. And thank you all for your encouragement and for the comments and the messages that you guys have been sending. So if anything else arises in this series, like I said earlier, I'll probably create an additional video to address such issues. And if you want to support this channel, if you want me to create more articles or more videos like this one, please feel free to subscribe and share my videos with others. And if you have ideas for other series that you want me to work or tutorials that you want me to create, you can drop them in the comments and I will check it out. So thank you guys for watching, and see you next time. Bye.